everyone. Welcome back to Let's Play Kingdom Hearts. So I took a couple minutes to look around for my wrist supports, and I still could not find them. And it's one of those situations where you see them and you're like, I want to remember where I put these, so I'm going to put them right here so I don't forget. And of course you fucking forget. There's a tournament being held at the Coliseum. I hear there's a great reward for the winner. Well, I don't really feel like doing that, so at least not right now. So we don't want to go into the Coliseum, we just want to head for that. Curious how heartless, because I mean, as we will see, nobody show a reasonable level of intelligence. Like, they are as smart as they were when they were like little people. Looks suspicious. Maybe it leads to another world. So we see that nobody's have the ability to plan and think things through, but the only indication that we get that the Heartless have this level of forward thinking, really, are these ships. Like, they don't, otherwise, I mean, Heartless don't appear to be that smart. Like, I'm amazed that it feels weird that they can pilot ships, because they don't really strike me as the type of creature that has that level of thought. You know? God damn, look at all these things. So we should be heading to Agrabah. Okay. Damn it. There we go. There's Agrabah. Bark.
And the keyhole?
The Heartless are searching for it now. I'm certain we'll find it soon enough. So that just leaves...
Jafar, I've looked everywhere for Jasmine. She's disappeared like magic.
The girl is more trouble than she's worth.
You said you had things under control.
Agrabah is full of holes for rats to hide in. But why worry about Princess Jasmine? With her, or without her, surely this world will be ours when we find the keyhole.
We need all seven princesses of heart to open the final door. Any fewer is useless.
Well, if the princess is that important, we'll find her. Find Jasmine, and bring her to me at once.
Don't steep yourself in darkness too long. The Heartless consume the careless.
Your concern is touching, but hardly necessary.
kind of throws you into the fray, doesn't it? So, I actually find Maleficent's warning interesting. Don't steep your heart in darkness for too long. The heartless consume the careless. And yet she seems like she's pretty steeped in darkness herself. Is there a matter of how much darkness one person can take, or... I don't know, it just was... it was interesting. So I have a mega potion. Jump up here. Mega ether. Money. Damn it, I tried to jump over, but for some reason it didn't jump. And yeah, I'm not getting up there. Not without something to boost me up. This door looks like you could possibly, yeah, you can. You can go in here. Alright, fine, we will lift it. Alright, that works. Gonna open this. It's another mega potion. And I keep praying that we do not have the green. So you'd think if we just set this down, we'd be able to just open that, no problem. But we can't. Because arbitrary game rules. So we might as well save again. I love Agrabah in the second game, I think, if memory serves. I don't really care for it so much in this world. And something else I've noticed that... it may still be an issue with... it was still even an issue with Birth by Sleep, as we saw. But I just am now realizing how empty these worlds are. I mean, you get kind of lost in the story, which is, you know, excellent. That's a fantastic thing. But these are supposed to be the worlds of Disney princesses and Disney worlds. I mean, supposed to have their own lore, their own people, their unique characters that are, you know, important to... yes and no to the story, but to the overall world building. So I do kind of wish we saw some of these characters around. And you know what? Actually, I'm going to go into abilities and... guard. 30% chance of unleashing a finishing combo. Okay, so we are going to equip that. And we still have no share. How the hell do I get the ability to see the HP bar? Like, on my next break, I'm actually going to look into that. Because this is actually starting to drive me a bit nuts. Where the fuck is that ability? I remember in previous Let's Plays, I'm pretty sure I had that ability by now. Like, I remember having that ability early enough that I beat Clayton in Deep Jungle with that equipped. I remember that. So, this is actually kind of annoying and frustrating. We're gonna move that and help that carpet. It flies off into the sunset. The carpet flew off for the desert, but let's explore the city more. Yep, let's open this. And open this. And even though we just saved, this is a shiny new save spot, so we're gonna save again. Because that is how we work. And how am I level 19 already? There's still several worlds left, if I'm not mistaken. I believe we still have, we have the rest of Agrabah to finish. We have Monstro. We have Neverland. We have, we have Halloween Town. We have Hollow Bastion. I feel like there's more that I'm not remembering. Like, I'm pretty sure there's a lot more to this as well. Damn it, I'm not even gonna be able to get back up there. Oh, we also have,
Who's there? Hello?
I'm Jasmine, my father is the Sultan of Agrabah, so that makes you a princess, but he has been disposed by Jafar, who now controls the city. Jafar? You haven't heard of him? He's the royal vizier. Vizier? Vizier? I don't know. He's gained evil powers and seized Agrabah. He's desperately looking for something he calls a keyhole. Jafar caught me trying to escape, but he helped me. Who helped you? We were hiding nearby, but he left a while ago to take care of something. Oh, I hope Aladdin's all right.
Where might I find this street rat? Jasmine, allow me to find you more suitable company, my dear princess. These little rats won't do, you see.
Jasmine, run!
Ah, the boy who holds the key.
All right. But we also have Atlantica. And I think that's it, but it's still a lot of worlds, and, like, we still have to fight in the end world, too, that I forgot what it's called. And, like, I remember when I first played through this game that I got at the very end of the game, like, right before the series of huge boss battles, I was at level 40. So... the thing stays. All right, there we go. So are we now in, I think we're now in a different area. No, we're not. We're just back at the old area. Okay. So now we can head out towards the desert. And we're going to save yet again. I'm actually curious, how far am I from the next 231? But, like, I remember having to do a hell of a lot more work for not getting quite as far. And I think I still had, like, the moderate all the way through. I'm pretty sure we still had the moderate all the way through when I was playing through that. So, like, I don't understand how I'm so high level. I mean, I'm not complaining. I'm just wondering, like, how the hell... It must be the new, easier beginner mode. I mean, I have to admit, this is easier than I even thought it would be. So, I mean, if you're someone who isn't very good at video games, or you're kind of like me when I first started playing video games, and you have kind of a high anxiety level for any sort of simulation, I mean, it's not a bad thing to... It's not a bad level to play at. Or if you're just looking for a nice, relaxing game.
Gorsh, not again! Genie, get rid of these guys!
Wish number one coming right up!
I see. Thanks, Sora.
Aladdin, what are you doing out here?
Same old stuff. Hunting legendary treasure. Just paid a visit to the Cave of Wonders. I found that magic carpet. And this lamp. Legend has it that whoever holds the lamp can summon...
Please, kid, leave the intros to a professional. The one and only Genie of the Lamp! Rub-a-dub-dub the lamp and have your dearest wishes granted. This winner is Aladdin! Congratulations!
Aladdin Rush!
Patience, my fine feathered friend. Any three wishes. Oh, one wish, a two wish, a three wish. Then I make like a banana and split. Our lucky winner made his first wish.
And let me tell you what a doozy that wish was.
So he has two left. So, master, what'll you have for wish number two?
How about making me a fabulously wealthy prince?
Whoa! Money, royalty, fame! Why didn't I do that? Okay, you asked for it. 100 servants and 100 camels loaded with gold. Just say the word and I'll deliver it in 30 minutes or less, or your meal free!
Hey, I'll even throw in a cappuccino.
No thanks.
Okay.
I think I'll put that on hold until we reach Agrabah.
Oh, why a prince?
You see, there's this... girl in Agrabah, named Jasmine. But she's a princess, and I'm... she could never fall for a guy like me.
Princess?
Jasmine?
Oh, that's right! She's in trouble, Aladdin!
What? Well, come on, let's get going!
Alright, so... because I want to continue to be able to use the Trinity symbols, we're just going to keep Aladdin out.
Ah! Fresh air, the great outdoors!
I guess you don't get out much, huh?
Comes with a job. Phenomenal cosmic powers, itty-bitty living space. It's always three wishes, then back to my portable prison. I'm lucky to see the light of day every century or two.
Say, Genie, what if I use my last wish to free you from the lamp? What do you think?
You'd do that?
Genie, it's a promise. After we help Jasmine.
All right. So we are almost to time. Oh god, it's that fucker. Alright, so we're gonna just go ahead and head in here, save one more time, and call it a video. Thank you for watching, and I will see you next time.